Let's see if it can run this.
Oh!
In this video, I will be using some UPS transformers to make a high current DC power supply. High voltage input, low voltage high current output with center tapping. Plus, I will also be using this giant 24 volts inverter transformer. Because it was not easy to solder this pointer, so I have placed it strongly at one point using the nickel strip, and now I'm going to repeat the process. Now comes the most difficult part, which is equal current division. The overall current that I need from this setup is only 35 amps continuous, because of which I've placed two MCBs. As you can see, the upper one is 25 amperes and the one below it is only 10 amperes. So this means that the upper MCB is going to carry 2.5 times more current than the one below it. So I will have to divide the wire accordingly. Here, as you can see, there are 7 strands. So two strands separated, and here we have 5 strands. So these two are the final output wires. Now comes the high voltage side. Now to the 220 volts input side, I've also placed 4 mm wires, very thick, since it is going to carry huge current and it is going to run around 1600 watts. So you have seen this bridge rectifier in my previous video. I am further upgrading it. I'm going to take positive from each set, okay, and negative from each set, similarly 2 AC wires from each set, so that I can utilize this rectifier to its max and use it in my power supply. Positive. Now the diagonal opposite of positive is negative. So guys, the machine is finally complete. Let's do the voltage measurement. As you can see, the output voltage is 48.26 volts with a maximum output current of up to 35 amperes. Now, this is a 24 volts DC motor. Let's test this one first. Working pretty good. Now comes my 24 volts and as you can see, around 27 amperes e-bike motor. Let's see if it can run this.
Wow!
Oh, very powerful power supply I have here. Now, I don't have many 48 volts DC motors, so I'm going to use this 12 volts DC motor, 32 amperes with this power supply. Okay,